Hey guys, it's Rich with your Monday spot on the Pagan Perspective. This week we're talking about the sun, moon, stars, solar systems, planets, and what role they have in our practice. I'm sorry about the lighting. I need to get this up really quick because I have to go to bed and wake up early tomorrow morning for another appointment with the VA. Let's hope everything goes fine. But anyway, into today's topic, or this week's topic, is a throwback topic, if I didn't already mention that. The topic in its entirety will be in the bottom bar, so go ahead and go down there and read that. But anyway, in my practice, I don't really, and if you can hear the air conditioner running in the background, please ignore that. I hope it doesn't come through on the audio too bad. Anyway, so I don't really do much with the sun and the stars and the planets and all that. Mercury retrograde doesn't really bother me too much. Saturn Returns was a bitch, but you know, hey, Kara can speak more on Saturn Returns than I can, that's for sure. If you're not taking her course, do consider it, especially if you're going through your Saturn Returns or know somebody that, who is going through their Saturn Returns. A little plug for you, Kara. But anyway, stars and planets don't really have much of an effect because I don't do a lot of astrology. I don't research astrology that much. Astrology is one of those things that I find it fascinating and I really like to hear about it. But whenever it comes to actually figuring out my own chart or figuring out somebody else's chart, I get one of those, like, the, you know, mind-numbing, oh my gosh, what the heck is going on here type situations, because I don't know nearly enough about it to even fill a thimble. So yeah, astrology and I, it's so confusing. It's one of those things that some people naturally come by it and they stick to it and that is their thing. I've never had that pull with astrology, and whenever I've tried to research it, it's one of those things where I need to have everything that I can amass in front of me, and I need to sit down and, you know, have it all memorized all at the same time. Sorry, my mouth's getting a little dry. But I need to have it all memorized before I actually start trying to articulate what the heck is going on. So for me, it's just one of those subjects that I've not gotten around to really doing an in-depth study on. So I don't really use it much in my practice. As far as the sun goes, again, the sun is more of a harsh, like burning, passionate energy. And I don't really usually need that type of energy. I usually like to work with the softer tones that the moon has. So I work a lot more with the moon phases. Now, that's not to say that I always consult the moon phase whenever doing a ritual or a spell of any sort. Sometimes it's just in the way that you word your spell work or word you're working and incorporate that into the phase of the moon that you're working with at that time. For instance, if you have a little dispute between friends that you're going through right now and you wanted to do a spell to kind of lighten up that situation, or, you know, make it so that you're not arguing as much, if at all, then if you're wanting to draw in love into that situation, yes, you can work with the waxing moon. But you know what? Let's say it's a waning moon. Oh no, what do you do? Do you wait till the next waxing moon? No, you don't have to. Instead, you word it so it banishes the hate or the discontent or whatever is going wrong in that situation. You banish that from the friendship or the relationship between you guys. And then whenever the waxing moon comes around, then you can add in the love and bring that in, because the absence of hate and discontent is love and acceptance and loving, you know, energies and whatnot and all that good stuff. So if you word your workings in a certain way, you don't really have to wait for the next moon phase to come through just to be able to do your workings. So that's something that I always like to tell people, is that you don't always have to wait to do a spell or to do any working in general. It's not something that you have to do. Some people, they like doing that just because that's the way they were traditionally trained or something like that, and that's fine too. I'm not going to disregard that. But I'm just saying that you don't always have to do that. But as far as the sun, not really a major player in my practice. Planets, I've already talked about those, not major players. The stars, same situation. So unfortunately, I don't have a lot to add into this week's topic. Let's say if this were a, you know, divination topic or something like that, I would have a lot more to say than whenever it's something like, you know, solar energies and whatnot. So sorry I don't have much to add on this week, and I'm sorry that this is a little rushed, but yeah, busy day, busy times, and yeah. I think next week is also a regular host week, I think. So I don't even remember what today is. So anyway, until next time, may you have a great day and a better tomorrow, and may you always have love, hugs, and ladybugs. Goodbye.